Great. How are you all? Hope staying safe at home. Good. Okay. Let me introduce. My name is Richa and I'm going to teach you science. But before starting, I just want to say you sit with your back upright and with no distractions. That's like a good student. Okay. So today we will start with the second chapter of science, components of food. Hope you have gone through first chapter very thoroughly. Is it so? That's like a good student. Very good. So in that first chapter, do you remember you have studied about the chemical substances present in the food? What were they? Yes. Yes. We call them as nutrients. So in this chapter, we will study in detail these types of nutrients. All right. There are basically five types of nutrients present in the food. First are carbohydrates, second are fats, third proteins, fourth vitamins, and fifth minerals. Yes, you can also speak with me. Come on. First are carbohydrates, second fats, third proteins, fourth vitamins, and fifth are the minerals. Very good. But beside these, water and roughage are also present in our diet. They do not provide us nutrition, but they have some other function. Now we will start discussing the components, the nutrients of food one by one. What was the first one? Yes, carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are the energy giving foods. That means they give energy to our body. There are two types of carbohydrates. First are starch and the second one is sugars. Sugars are the simple carbohydrates. That means they do not need much time and they do not take much time to absorb in our body. So they get quickly absorbed and they provide instant energy. Whereas starch is a complex one because it takes much time to break down and that is why it takes time to provide us energy also. So, in a hot summer day, you must have seen that if you feel hot, if you feel weak, low, you get instantly energy by what? Yes, by drinking Glucon-D in the water because it is a simple sugar and it provides us energy quickly. Excessive carbohydrates, they get deposit in our body in the form of fats. That means we should not take excessive of carbohydrates in our diet. Can you name some food items which have carbohydrates? Yes, think. Yes, wheat, rice, potatoes are rich in carbohydrates, bananas, all these are the carbohydrates. All these are energy giving foods. They are rich in carbohydrates. All right. Clear with the carbohydrates? Okay. So we will start with the second component, second nutrition. Yes, fats. Fats are also the energy giving. But when they give energy, they gives us energy when there are no carbohydrates in our body. When we consume fats, they get deposit in our body under the skin. And when required, they gives us energy. Is that clear? The other function of fat is they also keep our body warm. How? They make a lining under our skin, and when the cool wind comes, it doesn't allow air to enter our body and keeps us warm also. Fats, we can get fats from plants as well as from the animals. Can you name some food items of the fats which we get from plants? Think about it. Yes. Sunflower oil, mustard oil, groundnut oil, all these are the types of fats which we obtain from the plants. Whereas, what are the fats which we obtain from animals? Like ghee, butter, these are the fats which we obtain from the animals. Very important thing I really want to share with you. You know, if we consume much fats in our body, what happens? They get deposit around the vessels. How? I'll show you. Suppose these are the blood vessels from which blood flows. And what happens? these fats, excessive fats, they get start depositing a layer, second layer, third layer, and they just narrow that down this lumen. This is the lumen in our blood vessel. They narrow it down, so it becomes difficult for blood to transport through these blood vessels. So we should be very careful about the consumption of fats. We should take not much than 70 to 80 grams of fat per day. Is that all clear about the fats? That's good. Next we will start about proteins. Next we have proteins. Proteins are the building blocks of our body. What does that mean? Building blocks of our body. That means our body is made up of cells, and these cells are made up of proteins. Should I repeat? All right. These cells are made up of proteins, and our body is made up of cells, millions of cells, small cells, large cells. There are many sized cells of which our body is made, and these cells are made up of proteins. So we need proteins when we are growing, when we are in growing age, or when we get sick, our cells get damaged. For their repair, we also need proteins. Understood? So proteins are very important for our diet. In the same way, proteins can also be obtained from plants as well as from the animals. Can you name some proteins which we obtain from plants? Yes, you eat pulses daily. Pulses are the rich source of proteins. Soybeans and pulses, these are the proteins which we get from plants, and they are rich source of proteins. And what about the proteins which we get from animals? Eggs, meat, yes, fish. These are the proteins which we get from the animals. Understood? Hope now you have understood about everything from carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Next other components we will discuss in our next topic. Till then, I just want to say you read them very carefully, understand them and enjoy. Thank you.